Pleased to have right now the founder and director of the Abortion Survivors Network, Melissa Odin. Also, Newsmax contributor, good friend of the program, Chrissy Clark. Ladies, welcome in.
Thanks for having us.
I'd love to start with you, Melissa. You know, folks hear abortion survivor and they're like, I don't really understand the term, but you're living proof that it does happen. So if you can first talk about that and then we can go a little closer into the radical position that Waltz has.
Sure, that's the reality. Babies survive abortions. I am living testament of that. I survived a probably 31-week abortion forced upon my birth mother back in 1977. I was poisoned and scalded for 5 days before I was ultimately born alive. And, you know, as an abortion survivor, as a Midwesterner, I can tell you that I don't find Governor Waltz to be Minnesota nice at all, to women, to the preborn, to abortion survivors. His history speaks for itself.
Yeah, reproductive freedom, abortion is health care. We hear this over and over. And Chrissy, we hear it because they want to scare women in these battleground states that abortion for some reason is going away because of Roe v. Wade. But in reality, the stance that Waltz takes is just radical when it comes to the time and the window of killing a baby, an unborn baby. Talk to us about how they're using this as a wedge to scare women.
Well, it's incredibly misogynistic. I was just on a popular YouTube show called The Whatever Podcast, and I was sitting across from a girl whose full-time job is, well, corn, we'll call it. And she was telling me that she thinks that abortion should be allowed up until the moment of birth. And I was trying to just understand how you get to that point of view. But it is actually an incredibly misogynistic point of view to say that you can't figure out that you're pregnant within the first 6 to 15 weeks of your infant's life. And we can't even get to the point of arguing about how to go about adoption, how to go about changing the foster care system until we get people to realize that this is murder. This is exactly what is happening in Minnesota and California and these far blue states. It is murder at the 11th hour. And while Melissa, your story is incredibly impactful, please keep sharing it.
Yeah, it is so impactful. And, you know, obviously, one that's not told, I think, enough. So his policies, Melissa, he has actually done something that if it was a baby that survived an abortion would not have access to health care and live, which is exactly what happened to you. Tell us about Waltz's ruling there in the state.
Absolutely. Minnesota was one of the few states who had a reporting requirement to report out the number of babies surviving abortions and then what the outcome of that care was. And I want people to go to Minnesota's website, look through reports. You can see that in one year alone in 2021, they had 5 survivors and realized those are an undercount because we have babies born alive in late term abortions. We have continued pregnancy after early trimester abortions. Okay, this is a thing. We need to do a whole conversation about how this really happens and how many women carry an abortion survivor and people don't even know it because we don't talk about it. But what we do know is you can look at those state reports and I encourage people read them, become familiar with them. Contact your legislators, have conversations, post about it on social media. They are able to continue these attacks against survivors and women, and we are the ones who have the power to stop them. This election is in our hands because if we do the work, we look at them and we start talking about it, we can get people to vote in the manner that respects life and restores our nation.
Yeah, amen. You know, what they will talk about, though, is how he has his personal story with IVF. Chrissy, they really want to talk about this and how they went through fertility treatments, which a lot of women do, but it doesn't underscore where his stance is on radically abortion. I mean, that's the one thing that the other mainstream media doesn't take notice with. It's going to be this shined up, glowing version, kind of like what they're doing with his military service, even today with the allegations of stolen valor. They gloss over what they want. They just drive their own narrative.
Which is why people are consistently talking about the abortion problem, because they know that it'll galvanize women. It's why the mainstream media is honing in on this. But the thing that we've noticed is that it's not just a radical position. It is a radical trend throughout Waltz's career. We see it not just in abortion, not just, as you noted, in the stolen valor, but we see it in his anti-school choice positions. We see it in his ability to call socialism neighborliness, philosophy that's killed millions and millions of people is just neighborliness. No, it's called dictatorship. But he's just across the board a radical. And I think that really showcases to us the full picture as opposed to just one policy. One policy is part and parcel of who he is, a radical person.
We'll get back to some of the transgender and the parental things, but I do want to ask you, Melissa, we know how strong Planned Parenthood is when it comes to funding elections and super PACs, and it's massive, you know, and they don't even want women who go in to see an ultrasound because they might connect and they might actually look for a resource or perhaps consider adoption, consider the options. There are so many people that want babies. There are so many places that will help women struggling. Share a little bit of that if people are you know, considering. There are places you can go to get help, and it doesn't sometimes cost you a thing. There's a lot of churches and communities there, Christian groups, John Hagee, one of them in Texas. They have a home for women who are pregnant. Come in. We will take care of all your medical expenses.
Well, one of the stories I want to share with you that I think highlights this comes out of Minnesota. I met a mom a number of years ago who went to Planned Parenthood. This story is floating around the news, but I've known them for years. This woman went to a Planned Parenthood, had an abortion that she started at about 22 weeks. There was a dioxygen shot delivered to that baby's heart that should have stopped it. On the second day of the procedure, she went back and had an ultrasound performed to ensure that it had worked. Guess what? They found that there was still a heartbeat. Wow. That's when Planned Parenthood started to say, you know what? We don't usually talk about this, but if this baby is born, we would break the baby's neck. Okay, that's Planned Parenthood. Thank God this woman knew that there were people out on the sidewalk who were showing her real love and real support. That little kiddo is now in grade school, no thanks to Planned Parenthood. That is the difference between Waltz and his agenda and the people in the pro-life movement.
And that's it. It's brutal to hear, but don't let them fool you with this reproductive freedom, because this is exactly what they are for. What a testament to that mom and that story. Thank you for sharing, Melissa. Chrissy, really appreciate your thoughtful comments. And we know you're talking about this issue as well with your platform. Very important for all women to hear this other side. Thank you both.
Thank you.